mind focus on your natural flow of breath, bringing your attention here and now inside your body, inside this room for this hour of practice. And the postures and the asanas that we shape our bodies in, they're for our bodies to align, bring balance, harmony, releasing tension, toxins. And this breath that we breathe, this breath is for our minds, regulating it. Our breath and the mind are very much connected. When one is controlled, the other one is automatically controlled as well. Focusing on just these simplicities of breath itself and the sensations that you feel in the posture. Within this reconnection and reawakening, set an intention for this practice. Diving deep internally to a deeper meaning or purpose of what guided you here on your mat tonight. Breathing into your intention, make it very alive for you. And slowly open up the eyes, and we'll continue to center with breath, pranayama. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out the mouth. Interlace the fingers, draw the palms to the earth, empty lungs. Gaze down the back of the hands. Breathe in through the nose. Continue to slowly breathe in as the hands reach all the way to the top of the head. Full lungs. Exhale out the mouth, big active ha sound. Interlace the fingers midway down, palms pressed towards the earth, empty lungs. Again, inhaling through the nose, slight constriction of the airways, feel a vibration, maybe humming sound in the back of the throat. Exhale out the mouth, big ha sound. Feel that same vibration in the back of the throat as if you are trying to fog a mirror as you're breathing out. Inhaling, let's breathe together for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale out the mouth for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Two more here. Inhaling, gaze at the back of the hands. You're creating focus and also rehabilitating the neck as you're feeling extension, looking up. Exhale out of the mouth. Watch your hands as they draw down the center body. Even look at the back of the hands as the palms press down, now flexing the neck. Inhale, slow and take the breath coming in. Slow rise of your arms. Give yourself a permission to slow breath and movement down. Exhale, slowly release the breath, slowly draw down the hands, empty lungs. Pranayama 2, interlace the fingers underneath your chin, thumbs gently touch your throat, shoulders relax, keep mountain-like qualities in the body. On the inhale, you'll lift the elbows this time, nice full breath in here as the forearms rise up. And on the exhale, look up to the skies, big ha sound out of the mouth as your elbows and forearms come to touch. Then lower down, chin and elbow, and inhale, begin again, slow and take the breath coming in, slow rise of your elbows, full lungs. Exhale out the mouth, extension in the neck, forearms and elbows come to touch, squeeze the breath out, lower down, and inhale together, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, exhale out the mouth for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Two more, inhale, detail breath, feel and sound as you breathe in. Feel and sound as you breathe out. Let's take one more deep breath in for this breathing exercise. Go ahead and go at your own pace this time. Breathing in. Shoulders relax. Exhale. Look up. Extend the neck. Navel draw into backbone. Squeeze breath out. And lower down, chin, elbow. Return to mountain posture, Tadasana. Open heart, open palms. As your body's shaped into mountain, feel the breath you just practiced. That full breath in and out. This time in the postures, we'll be breathing in through the nose. So the lips breathe back out of the nose. Continue with this breath. Become reacquainted with it. Inhale the arms overhead. Interlace the fingers. Index fingers point up to the skies. Ardha Chaturasana, half moon. So we're squeezing the palms together. Straighten the elbows as much as possible, but relax the shoulders. Inhale, lengthen from the feet to the crown of the head. On the exhale, lean your hips to the right and upper body to the left, just about a quarter way down, testing waters. Inhale, come back in center, re-lengthen. Exhale, hips to the left, upper body to the right, and go ahead and repeat this way just a couple more times at your own pace. Left, right, left, right. In half moon, it's not about crunching the side body, but continuing with the length you created through your body as you're reaching out to the sides and the side bend. When you're feeling nice and satisfied, come back to center. So again, from the feet, crown the head, fingertips, inhale, lengthen, center. Exhale, hips to the right, upper body to the left, and hold. So lift your chin off the chest, look at yourself in the eyes. You're practicing aligning the shoulders and the hips in a horizontal plane. And feel free to observe and shift into that alignment. So if you feel like one shoulder's forward, one hip's back, just give yourself a little self-adjustment, awareness. Inhale, lift 1 inch up, just 1 inch. Exhale, deep breath and gravity. So not necessarily pushing with the muscles, but again, settling in with the breath and gravity. Inhale, come back in center, re-lengthen. Exhale, hips to the right, upper body to the left. Hips left, upper body right this time. Pressing down the feet. Lengthen, engage through the thighs. Draw the navel to spine. Bold elbows straight as much as possible. Squeeze your palms together like you want to eliminate the gap in between your palms. Nice. Inhale, lift 1 inch up. Exhale. Deep breath and gravity. Easing. Inhale, come back in center, re-lengthen. On the exhale, take your hands to the low back for Ardha Chakrasana, half wheel. So as you support your low back, we're preparing for a front body opener and a back bend. In your back bend, I want you to think about your heart rising upward. So inhale, tailbone down, bring your hips forward. Heart rises, and then gaze up to the skies. Pressing down the feet, lengthen, engage through the thighs, navel to spine. Every inhale, fill the lungs like a hot air balloon. Feel the chest rise. And then exhale, feel the extension of the spine and the support within the back muscles from low back, mid back, all the way through the neck muscles. Supporting low back, inhale, let's take it back up. Stack the vertebrae, head comes up last. Hands on the hips, inhale, prepare. Exhale, bend the knees, hinge at the hips, bring your upper body down to forward fold, Uttanasana. Bend your knees so much that the hands touch the earth. You can open up the feet, hip distance for more space. You can also take a block underneath your hands if you want a little bit more lift in the upper body. So let's shake our head no. Yes, soften the neck muscles, head feels heavy. And then walk at one place, bend your right knee, left knee. Lifting your right heel and left heel up. Hips massage at the top, knees, ankles, and toes gliding together. When you're feeling nice and satisfied with movement, come into stillness. For leverage, bend your knees some more, belly and thighs glued together, and we'll move into hands to big toe posture, Padukasana. So take your index middle finger, peace fingers, and wrap around your big toes. Your thumbs can be used as well with the grip. Inhale, lengthen spine. Exhale, pull the upper body down, bend your elbows right and left as you pull the upper body down. Now on the inhale, send the sit bones up to the skies. So as you are pulling down, the biceps are bulging. That's how much leverage you are applying within the forward folds. And on the inhalation, the sit bones will lift up to the skies as you continue to pull down. One more time, inhale, exhale, pull. Now release the grip, inhale, slide your hands to the hips. Bend the knees, move your chin away from chest and come up with a nice tall spine. Long and spacious. Return to mountain posture, Tadasana. Breathe in, breathe out, and feel your body, the front, the back, the sides, noticing some differences already, perhaps. Step your feet, hip distance apart for awkward posture, Utkatasana. Toes point straight ahead. Reach the fingertips forward, draw the shoulder blades back. So again, I'm going to turn to my side. Take a deep breath in, lifting the chest up. Exhale, bend the knees and send the hips back and down. So reevaluate your base and chair. Gaze down and you want to see your toes. Maybe even lift your toes up. Weight in your heels. Look at your knees. Make sure they're not turning in, flaring out, but they're pointing straight where your toes are. Thigh muscles cling to the bone. Draw the navel to backbone. Inhale, lift one inch up. Exhale, sink one inch down. Inhale, focus on lifting the heart, just the heart. Exhale, root the tailbone down towards your heels. Gratitude for this moment to practice concentration, steadiness in breath, and in posture. Now press through the soles of the feet, straighten the legs, come all the way up. Awkward posture too. Inhale, peel the heels up, come up the tips of the toes. As high as you can lift your heels up. Press the flesh of the big toes into the mat to help you balance. Squeeze your calf-sized glutes to the bone. Breathe in. Breathe out. You can stay here or bend the knees and send the hips back and down. So in this second set of chair, you want those heels lifted as high as you can still. Shoulder blades back. Shoulders align over the pelvis like your back's against the wall and you're sliding down the wall with a straight spine. If you're steady, inhale, lift one inch up. Exhale, sink one inch down. Concentrate, breathe. Now press from the balls of the feet. Inhale, straighten the legs, come all the way up. Keep those heels lifted as high as you can. Breathe in. Breathe out. Heels relax down. Step back together. Mountain posture, Tadasana. Calm the heart rate with your breath. Inhale, three counts in. Exhale, three counts out. Eagle posture, Garudasana. Inhale, the arms overhead, full lungs. Exhale, right arm underneath your left. So our first part of eagle bind could be holding onto the shoulders, feeling that space being created in between the shoulder blades. Half bind can be created with the fingertips up, or working into that full bind, see if the back of the hands connect, palms wrap, thumbs point towards your nose. So wherever you are in your eagle bind, it's beautiful. Relax your left shoulder down a little bit, as much as possible to level the shoulders. Breathe in, feet together if they're not. Breathe out, bend the knees, send the hips back and down into chair. You're down with the left foot, come up with the ball of the right toes. This is your awareness being shifted into the standing leg. Lift the right thigh up, cross it over. See if you're, again, your thigh muscles can connect, squeeze, wrap together, no gap in between your legs. Pull your right hip back, left hip forward. Inhale, lift the elbows, lift the chest up. Exhale, sink down deep in the hips and feet together. Inhale, fly up, full breath in. Exhale, left arm underneath your right. So as you come into your eagle bind on this side, I want you to observe something. Your shoulders are aligned over your hips right now. We want to keep the chest lifted and the spine tall, even when we're working into that eagle bind within the legs. So bend your knees, send the hips back and down. Keep the upper body back. Root down with the right foot, come up on the ball of the left toes, and then cross. So again, keeping the chest and the upper body back, shoulders aligned over the hips, lock in the belly muscles, Uddiyana Bandha. Breathe in. Breathe out. Concentration, focus, and feet together. Inhale, fly up, arms overhead. Exhale, arms relax down by your sides. Let's step to the middle or back of the mat. And realign back into mountain posture, Tadasana. We'll be entering a balancing sequence. So believe it or not, mountain is our first balancing posture. We're becoming aware of balancing the right and left side, the front, the back. And we're not looking for symmetry, because we're really asymmetrical beings. But again, we're looking for balance. Breathe in. Breathe out. Standing hand to knee, Dandamana Junushasana. We're down with the left leg. Bend your right knee. Flex the right knee up. Interlace your fingers around your right knee and hold. So far, starting position is here. Our first, and hamstring is an okay place to grab as well. First balance challenge or phase to master is a straight, strong left leg. So if the left leg's bending or shaking, just stay here and breathe in the starting position. Those that are creating some steadiness in the pose, draw the belly in tight. You can maybe come into phase two. Round the spine over the thigh. Interlace your fingers underneath the sole of the foot and hold, hold, hold. So again, evaluate the standing leg to be still, straight, and strong. Right thigh bone parallel to the mat. You're more than welcome to stay here. Otherwise, inhale, exhale, third position is extending. Sole foot forward. So look at yourself in the mirror. If you're extending, curl your toes towards your chest and stretch your chest towards your foot. The next phase of this is to tuck the chin and bring the forehead in the direction of the knee. Breathe in. And breathe out. Slowly release. Maybe a little bit more graceful than I did. Return to mountain posture, Tadasana. Breathe in. Breathe out. We're down with the right leg. Bend, flex, interlace, and hold. This time I'll watch you. So again, standing leg straight and strong. Cling the right thigh muscle to the bone. Belly in tight. Chest lifts. So here, right? Beautiful. Inhale, exhale. Second position. Those that are ready, and it may take a couple sessions of B Foundation series for you to progress in these poses. Extend, maybe the right sole of the foot forward to the front mirror. Here you're getting a nice opening of the low back, and within the back leg hamstring, when you're extending, the air leg hamstring as well. Inhale. And exhale, slowly come out of the posture. Control breath, control movement. Mountain posture, Tadasana. Breath in, breath out. Awareness, acceptance, dancer's posture, Natarajasana asana. So I'm gonna turn to my side for this. And we'll start by bending the right elbow, palm up. Now as your hand drops down by your hip, your palm will be open to the street side. Keep your palm open. We're down through the left leg. Bend your right knee. Watch where I'm grabbing. Inside of my right ankle. Draw the knees in, hips level. Reach your left arm up to the skies. Lift the chin and look into your eyes in the mirror. This is where drishti and focus lies. Inhale, lengthen through left side. Exhale, begin to kick back into your right hand. Without stretching just yet, just kick, just kick. Fill the footwork away from the body, slightly upward. Hinge at the hips to incorporate the stretch. Kick, stretch, kick, stretch. Lift the chin above the left fingertips like a horizon. Go over, connect to the two eyes. And slowly come back up. Control breath, control movement. Again, exiting a little bit more graceful. Mountain the body. Maybe it's one of those practices. Breathe in. Breathe out. Left side. Build into it. So again, your palm will be open to riverside this time. Bend your left knee. Hold onto the inside of left ankle. Strap is good. So now slide your hand down the strap so the elbow straightens. Better. Yes. Kick first, and then incorporate the stretch. Look into the eyes to connect with yourself. See yourself here and now, and see the alignment. The left knee is poking off to this side. Draw the inner thighs in. Tuck that knee behind your hip. Slowly come back up. Control breath, control movement. Mountain posture, Tadasana. Breathe in. Breathe out. Balancing stick, Tula Dandasana, Floating and Toppling Tree, Padmavrishasana. Let's be more at the back of the mat. Inhale the arms overhead, full lungs. Interlace the fingers and press the index fingers up skyward. So kind of like half moon preparation. Lengthen energy through your body, deep breath in. Exhale, big step forward with your right foot. Shift all of your body weight into the right leg. Your left toes can stay grounded to assist you with that stability. Or for your first balance challenge, left toes elevate and hold here. So biceps stay next to ears, square the hips forward. If you're steadying the standing leg, the upper body will come down and the left leg will float up. Biceps next to ears. Gaze down to the floor, a couple inches forward in front of you, breathe in. Breathe out, flow the arms down by the sides, toppling tree. Hands are facing to the floor. Internally drop the left hip down to level with the right. And then regress opposite way you went in. Inhale the hands overhead first. Belly tight, standing legs strong. Step your feet back and relax your arms down by your sides. Inhale, roll the shoulders up. Exhale, latissimus muscles down. Inhale the arms overhead. We got the other side to do. Yay. Interlace the fingers. Index fingers put up to the skies. Feel an energetic climb from the feet all the way throughout the fingertips. Breathe in. Breathe out. Big step forward with your left foot. Again, begin to make your shifting into the standing leg. Right toes can stay grounded or elevate them. Upper body down. Right toes up. Keep your biceps next to ears. Don't let your arms come in front of the face. Good. Inhale, exhale, flow the arms down by the sides, toppling tree. Standing legs straight and strong. See if you can straighten it where you are, or try lifting the torso up a little bit. Compromise and bring harmony to you and the ego. Inhale the hands overhead, belly tight, slowly come back up. Step your feet back, relax your arms down by your sides, and let's refresh, shall we? Let's get some water. Ooh, yes. I always do this. I forget my water at the front desk. Is it okay if I grab it? Thank you. Our Warrior Two sequence. So your attention will be turned to the street side and you'll be at the back of your mat. Mountain posture, Tadasana. Build your awareness from the feet all the way up to the crown of the head. And check in with the rhythm of your breath. Inhale, exhale, calm in the mind, relaxing into the body, Warrior Two, Virabhadrasana Two. Inhale, the arms overhead, full lungs. Exhale, take a big step to the top of the mat with your left foot. Reach the arms in opposite directions. So right now, the shoulders are aligned over the hips. Tailbone working downward, keep that going. Pivot left toes to the front of the room. Look down, see the left heel in the arch of the foot, or two heels can align up. Deep breath in. Now the upper body's gonna relatively stay the same as we bend into the left knee and come down with our hips into Warrior Two. And then check your stance too, so that the knee is aligned over the heel. If you find that the knee's extending past your toe like this, open up your stance a little bit wider. Maybe you have a little bit more room in the hips to come down. Inhale, lift the chest up. Exhale, sink the hips down, getting into those sensations of the inner thighs opening. Triangle posture, Trigonasana. Place the left arm on top of left thigh bone. Reach the right arm up to the skies. So here's a little shelf for you. That's nice, right? Forearm on top of thigh, allowing you to lift the torso upright. Lengthen through the spine to feel a subtle twist in the spine as you look up. Those that feel steady, breath and in posture, you may straighten the left arm down the middle of your left inner thigh. But if this results in you collapsing down with the torso, come back here. Forearm on top of thigh bone. Deep breath in. Exhale. Warrior Two. Sweep up. Commit into Warrior Two. Breathe in. Breathe out. Straighten out your left leg and pivot the feet to the river side, street side, excuse me, and right toes to the back wall. Breathe in. Breathe out. Bend your right knee. Sink back down into Warrior Two. Strive to bring equal amount of body weight between foot to foot. an equal amount of reach between fingertip and fingertip. Inhale. Exhale, sink down a little deeper. Get into those areas of your body you like to avoid. Inhale. Exhale, triangle posture, Trikonasana. Right forearm, right thigh bone. Left arm up to the skies. Release the resistance. Accept, surrender. Inhale. Exhale, those that are wanting more, straighten the right arm down the middle of the right inner thigh. Further open up the hips and the chest. One more inhale. And exhale, sit back into warrior two. Absorb every sensation that you feel. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly straighten out your right leg. Pivot the feet to the windows. Let's bring hands to hips. Now, the feet can come in a little bit. Toes in, heels out, preparing for wide-legged forward fold. You can keep hands to hips, or you can choose to interlace the fingers behind your back. So wherever you are, your chest is blossoming open. Pull the abs in tight. Inhale. Exhale. Hinge at the hips. Lead with your heart. Bring the upper body down. Wide-legged forward fold. Press the reach of the hands by squeezing the palms together. Now, if your palms don't clasp, just leave them closer to the low back so you have some mindfulness as you open up the rotator cuffs of the shoulders. Deep breath in. Exhale, release the binds. Take your hands right underneath the shoulders and lengthen here, clasp. So reach your chin away from chest. Reach your heart away from your hips. And yes, look at yourself in the mirror. Check out your lovely long spine. You're more than welcome to stay here striving for that length or explore deepening in your wide-legged. Deep breath in. Exhale. Bend the elbows. Pull the upper body down to the inner thighs. Maybe walk your hands in between your feet. Some may even reach your hands past the heels. So as you pull your upper body down, clasp, I want you to look at your spine in the mirror again. If you created a rounded spine, don't pull down more, but instead continue to lengthen. So those that have the nice long spine that you created, you're ready for the bind. Grab onto the outside edges of the feet, ankles, or the Achilles. Take a deep breath in, lengthen the spine. Exhale and pull the body down. So now we get to include some leverage, contracting the front of the body, quadriceps, core, chest, releasing the back side of the body. Breathe. Release and grip. Inhale, slide hands to hips. Bend the knees, belly to spine. Move your chest away from you as you slowly rise. Reach the arms out in opposite directions. Mindful exit back to center. Bend into the right knee. Step your feet together. Inhale, the hands overhead. And exhale, hands to heart. Rotate your attention forward facing. Immediately stand in mountain posture, Tadasana, with the hands to the heart. Give yourself this opportunity of stillness to consciously observe the state where your practice has brought you. Breathe in. Breathe out. Tree posture, Vrikshasana. Root down through the left leg. Bend your right knee and sway the right knee off to the side. So we can be here, leaning the heel against the ankle. Your leg bones are stacked right on top of each other as the right knee is externally rotating off to the side. If you want to challenge your balance, lift the sole of the foot to the inner calf, inner thigh, or the crease of the hip. By doing so, you can hold on to the foot. This is a little bit more advanced, just FYI. So, any of those places are fine, except the knee. Do not let your foot press against the knee. It's either below or above the knee. Inhale, the arms overhead. Interlace the fingers and press your palms up to the skies. Embodying a tree. Energetically root down through the left foot. Squeeze your left thigh muscle to the bone. Draw the belly in tight. Inhale, lift your ribs away from your pelvis. Exhale, relax your shoulders down the back. Palms are energetically reaching. Inhale. Exhale, hands together. Lower them down to the heart. Rotate, right knee in, right foot down, and express the hands to open by your hips. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe down through the right leg. Bend your left knee. Sway the left knee off to the side. So absorb and observe the state of your balance here. Lift the sole of the foot to the same equal position you practiced. Honor the knee by avoiding the knee. Mountain-like qualities in the body. This time, as we're feeling the rooting sensation below us, inhale, rising sensation of the arms overhead, hands together, exhale, center, hands to heart. Inhale, the hands overhead, exhale, hands to open, and release. Disturbances, restlessness, confusion, and doubt. Welcome in clarity, trust, surrender, courage, strength. Inhale. Exhale. Hands together. Lower them down to the heart. Rotate. Left knee in, left foot down. With the hands to the heart. Look at yourself in the eyes. Give yourself a smile. And a saluting bow in honorment of your presence on the mat. Turn around, lie down in your mid shavasana. Legs to the back wall, relax in the spine. So yes, take care of yourself, give yourself a drink, wipe yourself down. And when you're ready, extend your legs fully to the back of your mat, or to the back of the room, and allow the heels to click together, toes relax off to the sides if you choose to. Legs can be hip distance as well for more space. Settle the hips into the earth, neutral feeling in the spine. Shoulder blades can tuck inward and down the back, giving yourself some embrace underneath you and courage of the front body to be open and vulnerable. And practice stillness from the tips of the toes to the crown of the head. And allow the mind to follow the breath. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, belly rises. Exhale, 3, 2, 1, belly falls. Inhale, belly rises. Exhale, belly falls, just focusing on the simplicity of breath itself and the sensations that you feel in the posture. Threading the needle, Sutra and Dasana, flowless into wind relieving, Pavamukdasana, bend your knees, place the soles of the feet on the mat. Stretch your left leg up to the skies. Flex the foot towards you. Cross your left ankle on top of the right thigh. You can stay here gently easing your left knee to the wall behind you. Or, for more, thread the left arm in between your legs and hold on to your right hamstring with interlaced fingers. An advanced option is holding on to a couple inches below the right knee. Take a deep belly breath in. Exhale, actively pull the right knee in towards your chest as you ease your left knee gently behind you. Maintain both feet flexed in the dorsiflex position. This will protect the ligaments and tendons in the left knee. Another breath in. One more pull if you want a little bit more deepening. And then let's release into our wind relieving. Slide your left leg up to the skies and draw your left heel all the way down to the mat, guiding your right knee into the right shoulder space. Pull tight. You have an interlaced hand position just a couple inches below the right knee. Take a deep belly breath in. Exhale, pull the right knee into the right shoulder space. You most likely will feel a pinching sensation in your right hip. This is good. Another deep belly breath in. Exhale, pull right knee into the right shoulder space. And then slowly release. Bend your knees, rest both soles of your feet on the mat. We'll do the same flow for the other side. Now stretch your right leg up to the skies. Flex the left, the right foot, excuse me. Right ankle crosses on top of left thigh. Right arm threads in between your legs and hold on to your left hamstring. For more advanced, a couple inches below the knee. Relax your shoulders and relax your spine. Take a deep belly breath in. Exhale, pull your left knee into the chest as the right knee gently eases back. Both feet flexed. Shoulders relaxed, spine relaxed. Bend the elbows for leverage. Let your biceps bulge again. Deep belly breath in. Exhale, one more final pull if it's there for you. And then transition into wind relieving. Stretch the right leg up to the skies. Draw your right heel all the way down. Now guiding your left knee into left shoulder space. Pull tight. Other side, wind relieving. Be aware that your thigh doesn't push right into the ribs. That if it is feeling some contact, then guide the knee and the thigh a little bit more to the left side. Deep belly breath in.
Breathe.
Exhale, pull. And then slowly release your left leg long to the back wall. Reach both arms overhead, full body stretch. Take a deep belly breath in, stretching the diaphragm as you feel the ribs move away from the pelvis. On the exhale, bend both knees and pull them into the chest. Your hands can take a hold of the knees or your arms can wrap around them. So we're in Apanasana here, giving ourselves a lovely embrace. Now you can stay here just gently embracing yourself or take a deep belly breath in. Exhale and pull the thighs in towards the belly. Furthering to relax the spine and feel the low back releasing. One more time, inhale. And exhale, pull. From here, release the knees, plant the feet for bridge posture, Sutumbandasana. Slide your arms down by the side body and bring the heels inward towards the fingertips. As you gaze down center body, your knees are aligned with your hip bones. On the inhale, push down with your hands, arms, feet, curl the tailbone and lift your hips up into bridge. You can stay here with the arms down by your sides, or you can choose to interlace the fingers underneath you, folding the shoulder blades inward and down the back. Let's deepen with breath here. So on the exhale, lower the hips down 1 inch. And on the inhale, push your hips up by pushing down with your feet, arms, hands. Again, exhale, lower down 1 inch. Inhale, lift up. Chest rise into the chin. One more time. Exhale, lower down 1 inch. Inhale, lift up, support within the shoulder blades. On the next exhale, vertebrae by vertebrae, slowly lower down. Your option to do a second set of bridge or come into a wheel posture, Urdhva Dhanurasana. So bridges go up into bridge. Wheel practitioners, let me know you want to practice by spreading your hands wide on the ground next to your ears. Hug in the elbows, align with your shoulders. Now use your hands and feet to lift up to the crown of your head and hold. Just the crown of the head. This is your building blocks. Good. Draw the elbows in. Now push into the hands and feet. Drive your hips straight up. Heels down, getting into the hamstrings and hips lifting. Push your heart forward towards the front mirror. Hold for 3. Allow the neck to be in neutral, just hanging down heavy 2. And 1. Chin in, elbows in, abs in as you come down, wheels. Settle the hips, legs long to the back wall, and let everybody take a few breaths and observe. Checking in. Coming back into the rhythm of breath. Bend your knees into the chest. Legs extend up to the skies. Abdominal leg lifts, Chaturasana. So now we get to awaken within the fire within our bodies. Lift your hips up just enough until you can take your hands underneath the sacrum. This will protect your low back. Keep your low back grounded through the asana. Legs are squeezing together. Flex your toes towards you. Now, we can bend our knees a little bit to modify. Okay? breaths, let's begin with an inhale through the nose. And then exhale out the mouth. We can switch up that breath. Here we go. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, lower the legs down a quarter way to the mat and hold. Pausing in controlled space. Inhale, toes up 1 inch. Exhale, lower the legs down halfway to the mat. Squeeze the belly so tight your low back is grounded. Inhale, toes up 1 inch. Exhale, lower the heels down 3/4 away. Oh my goodness. Squeeze your glutes, inner thighs, fan your toes to the chest. One more time here. Inhale, toes up 1 inch. Exhale, allow the heels to hover 3 inches over the earth. Lift your head and shoulders up, look at your feet, and 3 controlled breaths. Inhale through the nose. Exhale the mouth. Inhale. Exhale, squeeze tighter. You got this. One more time. Breathe in. And breathe out. Press your low back into the mat. Lift your legs up to the skies. Bend into the knees. Reach the arms overhead for Eagle Crunches, Garasana. On the exhale, right arm underneath your left. And again, you can hold onto the shoulders or full Eagle Bind, whatever serves you. Now cross the right thigh over left thigh. No gap in between your legs. No gap in between your legs. Squeeze your legs together. Better. Now, inhale, prepare. Exhale, lift your head and shoulders up. Crunch. Inhale, reverse down. Exhale, squeeze up. Inhale, down. Exhale, elbows to knees for 10, 9, 8, 7. I want to hear that exhale as you come up. 5, 4, 3, 2, hold at the top, pulse mini crunches. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms overhead, legs out long, full body stretch, full body stretch. Take a deep breath in, re-energize. Exhale, left arm underneath the right. Bend your knees, cross your left thigh over right thigh. Now, before we begin with the movement, let's get the breath down because I feel like we're holding back. So without moving, I want you to inhale through the nose and exhale out the mouth. And make that audible sound. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, squeeze the belly into backbone. Better. Now inhale, prepare. Exhale, head and shoulders lift up, crunch. Inhale, reverse down. Exhale, squeeze up. Inhale down, exhale, elbows to knees for 10, 9, 8. Inhale down, exhale up, 7, 6. Rhythm and breath, rhythm and movement, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold, pulse mini crunches, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms overhead, legs out long, full body stretch. Take a deep belly breath in, everyone. Exhale, big sigh. Let's try that again. Inhale, big breath in. Exhale, let it go. Without holding back. Doesn't it feel good? Roll down the right side of your body, come down onto your belly. Sometimes after those Eagle Crunches, you're like, really? You want me to move my body right now? Yes, let's go straight into stabilizing the spine. Cobra posture, Bhujangasana. So I apologize for this big tower. Here, just kind of watch the room if you can't really see me and want to. Spread your fingertips wide underneath the shoulders. Hug your elbows into the ribs. Legs are together like a snake tail. On the inhale, push down with your feet, tailbone. Lengthen the spine and lift the heart up into cobra. So here we're using a lot of back muscles, little to no hands. So let's try lifting our hands up and see if our chest stayed where we left it. Inhale big and exhale, lower down. Locust posture, Salabhasana. Now reach the arms down by your sides, palms on the mat. On the inhale, push your hands into the earth, lower body is anchored, lengthen the spine and lift the heart forward and up. Now you can stay here, or if you want more, lift your palms up, spread your fingertips to the back wall. If you want even more, lift and extend your legs up, pushing your pelvis into the earth, lengthen the spine and splay the collarbones. Breathe in, and breathe out. Lower down. Bow down your asana. Bend your knees. Curl the heels in. Let's get right into it. Grab onto the outside edges of your ankles. So, are we able to access both ankles? Yes? Ooh, very nice. If not, you can do half bow. So look at me for half bow. Put your left forearm here. Bend your right knee and hold on to the outside edge of your right ankle, and you can go half bow here, okay? When you're ready, everyone, inhale. Kick back into your hands. Your chest will peel off the mat. You can stay here. Please respect low back, but if there's more for you, kick back and up to lift the frontal thighs. Inhale, blossom chest. Exhale, firm to back muscles, and then slowly lower down. So keep a hold of your ankles as we're going to come into a second set. So half bow practitioner slips to the other side. You got it. Here we are for our second set of bow dhanurasana. Inhale, kick back. Feel your chest up. Root your tailbone down and firm to the back muscles. Breathe in and breathe out. Slowly lower. Release your legs long behind you, arms by your side. Look to the right, lift toes on the mat. Let's just take a moment to feel the fertile earth underneath us. Maybe close your eyes and focus on the spot in front of you. Inhale, three counts in. Exhale, three counts out. Lift your head, look to the left. Riders on the mat. Give the other side of your neck a gentle stretch. Center the chin, place your hands underneath the shoulders, and inhale, rise up into tabletop. Exhale, sink the sit bones down towards your heels into child's pose, balasana.
In the quiet of a shadow.
So in your child's posture, encourage the torso to lengthen forward, the arms to lengthen forward. Relax the forehead.
Darkness moves upon you.
Deep grounding
like
breaths.
A cloud across the moon. You're aware in all the silence of a constant that will turn.
Slowly walk your hands towards you. Rise up.
Like the windmill left.
Come to the very top of the mat for sleeping hero, Supta Virasana. And a block can aid you underneath the sit bones. So if it's really uneasy to sit like this, block can aid you. You can stay here just working on stretching out the front of the legs or move deeper into sleeping hero. So those that are coming in sleeping hero, knees open the width of your hips and bring your hands behind you, fingertips pointing forward. You can stay up on your hands, lift your chest up, relax your head back. Now for my anatomy, coming down to my elbows with the block underneath me doesn't really serve me. So those that have the block underneath you, let's just say stay up on your hands. For those that want a little bit more, you can come down to the elbows one at a time. Just make sure both knees stay grounded at all times. And the shoulders are the next step. You can tuck your fingertips underneath the shin and then very slowly lengthen the elbows and settle the shoulders. Let's stay here for three deep breaths. Breathe deep into the belly.
Drives you further.
And then deep in the chest.
Confusion. As you lose your sense of ground.
Now as you're coming out of sleeping hero, do so mindfully. So from your shoulders, bury the elbows into the earth. Elbows sneak back behind you. Elbows to hands. And then come all the way up, rising for camel posture, Ustrasana. Camel pose, we're gonna use our block. So take your block in between the upper inner thighs. This is going to help you with alignment, knees and hips together. Also feeling the action of camel, okay? So if you don't mind me quickly going into it first, you can see going in and out safely is very important, and then I'll let you try. So thumbs to the sacrum, very important to squeeze belly in tight, tailbone down, hips forward, heart rises. We know this, yeah? Heart rises. You're more than welcome to stay here. An advancement you can take is fingertips down towards your heels. Heels are a little bit more lifted, so maybe that's available for you. Now, as you're exiting camel, you're exiting opposite. Hands low back, stack the vertebrae, and then take a seat. Okay, so we started. That's fine. Stay here for three more deep breaths wherever you are in camel.
Just breathe.
Remember to emphasize the heart rising. Gaze up to the skies. Hips staying high over the knees. Mm-hmm. That's a tricky part when you're going towards those heels. Now come out opposite way went in. Hands to low back. Stack the vertebrae. Head comes up last. Remove the block from in between you and bring your sit bones down towards your heels. Let's take a moment, shall we? Rest the back of the hands on that, palms facing upward. Take a breath in. Breath out. Feeling a neutral spine and observing the benefits of your practice as they're presenting themselves to you. Hands in front of you, tabletop. We'll do a few transitional breaths in cat-cow. Fingertips are spread underneath the shoulders and hips are directly over the knees. Push the earth away from you so the shoulder blades are broadening. Gaze between your hands. Deep breath in. Exhale. Tuck the chin in the chest, belly to spine, arching shoulders, low back to the skies. And on the in-breath, let the belly scoop down. Heart lifts. Gaze up. Exhale. Round back into cat. Pull the belly into backbone. Squeeze the breath out. Inhale into cow, ribs move away from your pelvis, heart lifts, and ending one more time into cat pose. Neutral spine from there, curl your toes underneath you, inhale, exhale, lift your hips up and back, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Spread your fingertips, shoulder distance, feet hip distance. Push the earth away from you, melting the chest and belly to the thighs. Now the knees can bend here, so if you're feeling a lot of tension in the backside body, bend those knees a little bit. And yes, walking the dog can be another variation. Lifting one heel at a time, bringing one knee into the other, into the chest, feeling the right and left side of your body. Three, two, and one. Creating stillness in down dog from here. We'll move into pigeon pose with a transition of a three-legged down dog. So equilibrium in your hands. Draw the belly in tight. Inhale your right heel up to the skies. Point your right toe to the back wall. Deep breath in. Exhale. Bring your right knee underneath the body. Land the right knee behind the right wrist. And allow the left leg to lengthen behind you. So, I'll show you with the leg that you can see. A couple options is sitting right on the heel, square in the hips. So you don't want to be hanging out too far to the right or too far over to the left. You want to find that center and pigeon. You can bring the foot out from underneath you for more of a triangle. If you have tight hips, you'll find that there's a space from thigh to earth. In that case, grab your block and place it right underneath your right thigh.